Hey guys, welcome back to my channel today. In today's video, we are going to be testing out a pretty exciting new product from Benefit. If you guys are unfamiliar, Benefit is a makeup brand that really heavily focuses on brow products. This was the product that was missing from their line, if I do say so myself. Microblading is the biggest thing nowadays. So many people do it, including myself, and they finally made a pen of their own. This is the new brow microfilling pen from Benefit, and this is actually something I purchased myself. So if you guys want to know all about my thoughts on whether or not I think this is something that is actually an innovative product from them, or if I think this is a miss, then just keep watching. All right, so let's talk about this new brow microfilling pen from Benefit. Now, a lot of you guys have tested out products like this in the past, and the feedback that I've received from you is essentially that they bleed on the skin, they are drying on the skin, so you can't remove them like at all to save your life, or the shade range is basically crap, or they don't last and they actually dry up in this tube within a couple of uses. So this is something that I've been really interested in figuring out myself. When Benefit put a product out like this, I was just so incredibly interested in it. I have had personally my brows microbladed before, and I did it actually in November of 2019. So now we're getting close to the year mark, and I have been noticing certain areas getting lighter. Overall though, the look is still relatively intact, but I do think there's a couple of spots that I can definitely sharpen up. So this is a perfect time to test something like this. And because I've seen a real microblading result, I wanted to compare the two also. So just looking off of Sephora's website, the brow microfilling pen from Benefit runs $25 American per pen. In Canadian dollars, that is $33 Canadian for my Canadian viewers. And there are actually four shades in this. Now, this is very interesting because they do offer a wide variety of shades with their Gimme Brow product, for instance, which is actually one of my favorites. It's just like a tinted gel. I actually see 10 shades in this Gimme Brow product, which is actually one of my favorites. So it's very interesting that they actually kept this to four. Apparently, they've done a ton of testing when it comes to different skin tones and brow hair colors, and they've said that these are the four that cover everyone. Well, let's just see about that, right? The first shade is blonde, the second one is light brown, the third one is medium brown, the fourth one being deep brown. Now, the shade that I picked up is actually medium brown, and I will talk about what I think about this shade in particular, but this is the, you know, outer packaging that it comes in. It is still really cute Benefit style. The silver packaging of this Benefit product matches the Gimme Brow and the brow gel and like the Precisely My Brow. All of the other brow products have this gorgeous silver platinum look with that pink font. So they look really ritzy and kind of high end, and that's how it should be because the price point is fairly high considering its drugstore counterparts. What it says online here is that it's a waterproof, smudge-proof ink pen with a three-prong tip, effortlessly creating microfine hair-like strokes. So when I just took a look at testing this on my hand, I just wanted to see how fast it was going to dry before I put it on my face. It does say to apply on clean, dry brows, but this is something that I applied to my hand just to kind of see like, wow, like how easy are these strokes, first of all? They're very micro thin, you guys. In my opinion, I think they do a great job with that. When you actually stroke it on the hand, if you press firmly, it has a little bit of a thicker result. So make sure that you're just flicking the pen really, really lightly on your hand. You don't want to actually press this down because it will make them thicker and actually give slight bleeding effect to the skin. You can see the bunch on the left is just me pressing really hard. And then the other ones are the light strokes. So the light strokes is very, very crucial when it comes to applying this thing. You can definitely see here that this is a warm brown color, and for my brows currently, I actually think I'm going to try the next shade up when I repurchase this because it is slightly still a little bit light for me. So I can't exactly add hairs to my existing brow hair with this color. It's going to just look more like a light tint instead of actual hair strokes. Now before I applied it to the brows also, I wanted to rub my hand all over my strokes on the hand to see if they would bleed or smear. Now this thing dries really, really fast. We're talking like 15 seconds or so. It's definitely evident that it's a dried product on the skin. I do find that if I'm rubbing really, really hard on my skin, I find that it does tend to fade and slightly smear, but we're talking like really vigorous rubbing across the hand. So this is something that is unrealistic and it's not going to be happening in a real life situation. However, this is a product that when I took just some makeup remover, I was able to remove it very easily off of my hand. So just so you guys know, the drying time is very impressive and it is easily removable, which is something that I know a lot of you guys have explained in the past, that some other products really just stain the skin and it's really impossible to remove. Now, the thing that made it really easy for me was because I had a microbladed result to guide me through when I was applying this to the brow. You can see that my hairs are actually fairly dark brown just by nature. I know there's lots of people out there that actually have black brow hairs. So even at the deep brown level, I'm kind of wondering if that shade will truly cover people that have darker hair like that. So it's just kind of something I'm just thinking about. But I do think that this shade was fairly okay for a match. They do have a little chart here on Sephora. If you actually do look at the product and kind of see like, oh, well, what like shade am I in? It does give you like, based on other Benefit products that you've picked up, they give you a bit of an idea. But obviously, if you've never tried Benefit brow products before, it's going to be a little tougher to guess your shade. So you guys can see here that filling in my brows is really effortless. It's very easy because I have basically an outline to follow. For those of you that have very, very few brow hairs and you're really just drawing, this is something that I do think, even though it's easy to use, I think it's still gonna take a little bit of time to perfect how to do a stroke without pressing too hard. You know, making it look really hair-like. There's lots of people that can do that very effortlessly, like the artists, I'm sure, can just grab a pencil and do it. But for me, I am really terrible at art. I'm not an artistic person at all. So I found just kind of like holding it and stuff with the three prong, I felt like I had to be careful with like, okay, make sure it's still a light flick, nothing too hard. And when you're getting to the point of the brow where it's like the arch, you can actually like make it go horizontally. So then you just kind of do straight hairs downward, kind of like how a natural brow would form when you have a natural brow after the arch. It just kind of sits flat. It's not going to stick straight up anymore unless you're doing like a laminated look or something like that. I think ideally products like this are meant for people that have, I would say, a little bit of hair already. If you're like completely bald, this is gonna take a lot of dedication to learn how to do something looking very natural and very hair-like, right? But as you're learning, if you can definitely thicken things up with this. This is something that I think stays put. And I actually just used a clear brow gel over top, which is just like the 24-hour brow setter. I found that it didn't do anything to disturb the micro pen underneath. So that was something that was really, really helpful. I'm actually going to also apply the Gimme Brow over top of it because the Gimme Brow is a tinted brow gel. And I wanna see just kind of how it looks just over top of it and just kind of see, like, is it gonna look even more full or is it gonna look too blocky at that point? Okay, so I'm just gonna look over here, lift my head up so you guys can see, and I'm just putting it over the hairs a little bit. I only set the tail of my brow, so I'm not gonna go too much. This is really easy just to make it look even more full. You guys can see that. So it's looking really, really full at this point. In real life, it's still looking still hair-like though. I don't want it to look too much like block brows. And I do think it's looking really, really good. The one thing I will have to follow up with you guys on in a hits and misses is if this lasts the test of time, because this is something that I think a lot of you guys have questions about in particular. A lot of people have purchased, like, the one that I think about the most off the top of my head is the Maybelline Tatte Brow, I think is what you call it. It is a drugstore microblading pen. And I think the biggest downfall of that one, just from reviews and hearsay, is that people think that it dries out really, really quick. So it's not like a nice long-term investment because you're using it three times, then you can't use it anymore. So this is something that I'm gonna make sure I'm keeping the cap on. Like when I use it, I put the cap directly back on to make sure that I'm keeping it nice and moist. Hate that word. That way it'll have its best chance at staying nice and wet and able to, you know, provide the product necessary to get the look that you want. Overall, would I recommend this? Yes. If this is something that's in your budget and something that you're genuinely curious about, I do think it's something that's worth trying. They don't have any mini sizes of this currently, but knowing Benefit, they most likely will put something out. So that's awesome. This is something that I think is a really, really nice, innovative product. I knew they would come out with this thing, so I'm glad they finally did. And this is something too that will solve a lot of people's problems, because when it comes to microblading, it's a significant financial investment, as well as the fact that you do have to upkeep it every year, year and a half, something like that, because it does fade just like a temporary tattoo would. I'm hoping if this thing lasts a long time that it's going to give people another option to have full brows without having to go through that particular process if they don't have the financial means or if they simply just don't want to do it. This was just a really quick review. I hope this was very helpful for you guys. Thank you so, so much for watching. Do let me know if this is something that you have your eye on or if you're gonna pick up. Until my next one, guys, take care, stay safe. Bye, guys. You and me, everything that we've been through has made us strong. You won't believe we've had our gray, but sorry, there's a light inside of us. It shows the way.